I wanted to know, on these yes and no foods here, you see, you can have fruit?
Yeah, you can have fruit on the McCombs plan, as long as it works for you. Now, for most people, it does work. It's okay. One of the questions I commonly get asked is the fruit question, because the original Candida diet was created in the late 50s by an MD, Dr. Ryan Truss. He used nystatin as the treatment choice, and nystatin doesn't work systemically, so he wasn't able to address systemic infections. So part of his protocol was to try and starve Candida out of the body by not giving people fruit. Now, fruit on the McCombs plan generally is okay as long as you're following the plan outlines and taking the Candida force. It works. Fruit has vitamins, minerals, antioxidants, fiber. It also has the natural form of fructose. Certain sugars are needed to run our immune system. Our white blood cells require sugars. But again, he was trying to starve it out simply because he had an ineffective approach for getting rid of the Candida. We find that on the McCombs plan, you don't have to eliminate fruits, and unless, of course, you have some very strong food allergies. But we've even had people who have had lifelong banana allergies after 3 or 4 weeks on the plan be able to eat bananas. It was due to a digestive imbalance, not a true banana allergy. So if it works for you, it should be fine. We always encourage people, when they're doing the plan, eat the foods that work for you from the yes list. And then when it comes time to add foods back in, only add in the foods that you know, work for your body to promote health.
Okay. So then if we can eat fruit, is it okay to eat it in like a pureed or a blended form?
No. You don't want to bypass the body's own digestive process. If you puree it, blend it, juice it, you're concentrating the fruit sugars. You're making it too available too fast, too quickly. And that can feed the Candida.
Don't
so you want to go through the old process of chewing your food, and that's how you make your juice. You chew it.
Okay. And you say you can have brown rice. What about oatmeal?
No. Just brown rice is the only grain that we've ever found works. It's a carbohydrate. It's a protein. It has components of each, but it's a neutral grain. It works on the plan very well and has for 19 years. Oatmeal will actually cause a little bit of irritation to the intestinal tract.
Okay, and no butter?
Nope.
Okay. All right, and then you say no milk or soy milk even. You have a vitamin D deficiency,
if you have a vitamin D deficiency, you're not going to get the vitamin D you need from drinking milk. You're going to have to take a vitamin D supplement. And, you know, most people don't know that most of the United States has vitamin D deficiencies. Even people who live in sunny states tend to be covered up all the time or indoors all the time and have run vitamin D deficiencies. So you need to take, you're better off getting outside to get some sunlight, and then secondly, getting a good vitamin D supplement.
Okay. And one more quick question. What about the apple cider vinegar? Is that okay?
Starting in week 9, no vinegar in the first 8 weeks.
Okay.